Good morning and welcome to Falcon TV. It's Thursday, February 11th, 2021. I'm Nadia, along with the rest of the FTV crew.
MIT researchers have developed a type of neural network that learns on the job, not just during its training phase. These flexible algorithms, dubbed liquid networks, change their underlying equation to continuously adapt to new data inputs. The advance could aid decision-making based on data streams that change over time, including those involved in medical diagnosis and autonomous driving. This is a way forward for the future of robot control, natural language processing, video processing, any form of time series data processing.
It turns out teaching kids outside could help them learn better, and especially during a pandemic. It might be better for their health. That's why a lot of schools are now experimenting with holding classes outdoors. Yep, even during winter. We've learned you can create any space outdoors and turn it into a classroom, said a public school principal in Dallas that has been holding more classes outdoors since COVID hit. Even if your child is fully remote or attending all indoor classes, you can still bring a learning environment to the outdoors. They may not think that in the Northeast, especially with the snow that was just dropped, but teachers were bringing students outside to work, like the dance classes. And speaking of dance classes, Mrs. Gaskell, along with the dance teachers of Gammy and Creek and the dance students from all three schools, collaborated to put on a special at-home performance. I had a chance to sit down with Mrs. Gaskell to talk about this. I am Nadia Bukas here with Mrs. Gaskell from Oakcrest High School, and we are going to talk about the District Dance Collaboration Project. So, Ms. Gaskell, who was the mastermind behind the project? Like, who created it and who thought of it?
So, Ms. Ashley Tabano, the dance teacher at Cedar Creek High School, reached out to Ms. Katie Resch and myself about ways to get our dance composition students excited about doing a project from home while we were virtual for the 2 weeks after, right around the holidays. Came up with this idea that would be fun to get all of our dance students working on something collaboratively together. Okay. So the District Dance Collaboration Project was born. Between the three of us, we came up with two songs to utilize, and then we split our kids up into those two different songs. So each student had a chance to contribute to the story of the dance. So one of the titles of the dances was called 6 Feet Apart.
Feels like miles, 6 feet apart, so far. So far, but so close, like a star out in the cosmos, can't touch the beauty I see. That's how it feels at 6 feet.
The song basically talks about what we're all dealing with, is having to make connections with people while we're apart from each other.
When I was young, I was suspicious, but it's true. Time sticks like glue. I feel so blue. Here missing you. So I think I'll build a time machine and go back to a time when we didn't meet, and there's just 6 feet on the ground when I came around. That's not allowed. I can't go back now.
And the other piece of music that we selected was called Waiting for the World to Change. Which again, I think many of us right now are waiting for the world to change, yeah. So we can get back to kind of a little bit of a normal life. So then it was up to the students to figure out how they wanted to portray that idea through movement. And so what you saw was what they came up with. And we were able to piece it all together.
All right. And what was the purpose of the project, would you say?
So we want our students to still feel like they have a voice in the art world. Dance is a great way to express yourself. And especially when you're going through times of anxiety or stress or and need an outlet, a creative outlet, to be able to express yourself and deal with some of these emotions, this is a great way to do that. So we wanted to teach our students that dance is a way to use your voice and to make a statement, and also just to share the love of dance with others, and hopefully other people could connect with this and make it personal for themselves.
Great. That's really great. Do you have any additional information that you want to talk about?
Just that we love doing projects together and working collaboratively with each other. It was really fun to bring all the dance programs together. I know oftentimes we think of the other high schools as our competitors. Okay. So every now and then I know there's always a summer musical program where everybody gets to come together. So this was a nice opportunity for our dance students to come together in a positive way.
Great. Thank you so much for talking with me.
Thank you, Nadia.
Thank you.
Today in Black History, we look at newcomer and inspirational poet Amanda S. Gorman. Her work focuses on issues of oppression, feminism, race, and marginalization, as well as the African diaspora. Gorman was the first person to be named National Youth Poet Laureate. She published the poetry book, The One for Whom Food Is Not Enough, in 2015. Just because you are young doesn't mean you don't have a voice.
The Math Club will be meeting virtually at 3:30. Time may be relative, but it's time to start to plan Pi Day. Please use the Meet link on Google Classroom.
Today, we conclude our look at all the wonderful crew of Oakcrest, all our maintenance and custodial workers, as we express our appreciation for their dedication and hard work. Today, we want to give shout-outs to Stadi Reeves and Shipping, who helps keep things organized, Blanca Chacon, who works from 3 to 11 p.m. and takes care of the front offices for all the admin and visitors, Chris Rabush, who looks after several sectors of the school areas, and we can't forget Lou Critelli. He is a vital part of Oakcrest, taking care of everything from the fire alarms to temperature issues and wobbly door handles and other nuts and bolts the school may need tightened. To Blanca, Chris, Stadi, and Lou, and all the other workers who help take care of the school running smoothly and staying clean, we thank you and appreciate all that you do.
Before we go, we thought we would leave you with some inspiring words for Valentine's. Tough times when there's people like Aristotle, Frost, Plato, Shakespeare, and so many others. But we decided to leave you with these words from J.K. Rowling and Harry Potter and the Deathly Hallows. After all this time, always, says Snape. Well, that's all for today. So from me and everyone here at Falcon TV, have a great day.